So I am Shruti Priya, the HR manager of Aircruise Aviation Private Limited. I'll be talking about why pilots, cabin crews, and AMEs are very successful bloggers and why they should start blogging and what plus points they have in compared to the other bloggers. So to understand this better, I'll be sharing my screen. Yes, so what is blogging? Blogging is actually just putting your day-to-day life journals on a web or on a social media. Basically people understand blogging is something that, that we are day-to-day watching on YouTube or any other social media platforms about their day-to-day lives or any new information they will be giving on social media. So how did it started? Where did it started from? So basically what happened in the initial stages when blogging started, people started it as their part-time job or something like they wanted to do as their pastime job or passion. So it was actually started as a passion. People just thought of sharing their likings or some useful information with other people around the world. This is how it all started. But because there wasn't much income in blogging, so they usually added it with their full-time jobs. They usually do it between the hours when they are free, when they have free time from their full-time works, like morning from 6 to 8 or at night time. Usually they're done after their office hours, and maximum they can put their efforts for a week, 5 days a week or a 2 day of week, not more than that. They cannot do that because of income and payment issues. Initial blogs were like only regular. They started researching about what people think, what people want to know, what are the needs of the people, and they just started blogging about those, and they started being an influencer or giving their thoughts about a certain topics. So there were people who they may make mistakes, and these type of mistakes happens regularly, but people started learning from them. Then they started doing their research much better and giving a much better informations to the people they are connected to, and this is how their subscribers and followers started increasing. Now what happened after this started, people started earning from their bloggings, and the payments were so good that they thought of shifting their career to a full-time blogging, and this blogging life gave them many benefits, including the travel life. Any blogger who wanted a travel life, they can travel a lot. They don't have to think about the money or any other problems we face while traveling. People started knowing them, they started getting helps and all. We have in a research it was found that a blogger's highest, till date, any blogger who has earned the highest amount is around $500 million in a year, which is a huge amount. And it was expected that people can earn around $3,000 a year, which is much, and I think much more than people earning in their normal day-to-day work, daily jobs. Other things that full-time bloggers can expect from their careers is they can increase their writing skills. They can be a good content writer. They can work with big companies who can promote them on social medias. People like big companies like HUL and all, they started sponsoring these influencers because people are much more connected to them. People are relying on them, and people are accepting what they are saying. So they started cooperating with those, collaborating with the full-time bloggers. Then the bloggers can also think of their posts. If they want to go for a post or they want to write a blog, they can do it from the very start. Like if if you want to post the thing on your social media or on your blogs one week after 1 week. So people started doing it from the first day of the week, and then they post it on the last day of the week. So this made them this gave them a thing like a place to work on, give their imaginations increase their abilities to work on anything. This gave them new ideas and overall build their personality. Talking about the sources that a blogger needs. So resources, like what resources a blogging can give to any of the blogger is that they will have their own individual, if they want, they can have their own individual blog. They can start it as a like part-time and then move to a full-time blogger when they start earning money. Sources of money, they like bloggers have many sources of money, not only a single source, but they will have a multiple source of earning. Some people like to just shop. You can become a mystery shopper if you are a blogger. You don't have to pay, you will be paid for just shopping, which obviously like sounds fun. Then you can make money from running ads through your blogs, and even other companies can approach you for running their ads on your blogs, which can earn a great amount of income to any blogger. Talking about the important links of blogging. So if you don't have a link or you don't understand why you should do blogging, then there is no use of doing a blog. If you don't connect with your people, if you don't understand them, if you don't know what you want to showcase on your blogs, then maybe it would go in a hustle and nobody will follow you, or you don't get any followers. So self-awareness and confidence is very important. You need to understand what you are showcasing, what you are giving to the people, which needs you to get better and get your contents much better, which is also very very much needed. Then if you are putting your blogs on the on any social media, but you don't have a connection to promote your videos, or there are no one to promote it on other social medias, you cannot gather much rush on your profile, or people would not know about you, or you will take time in growing. You will need a lot of time, maybe 4 to 5 years to grow in blogging career, and that may take much time than you have expected if you don't have a like networking or a good network, or you don't start establishing a good network when you start a blogging career. Next, talking about the main topic of our PPT. That is why it is very popular among cabin crews, pilots, and AMEs. Why these people are much better in blogging than others, and why they should go for blogging. So first is, social media is becoming a very popular site or very popular platform among people. People now are moving towards these blogs, except from TV channel, the common platforms for entertainments. They are now moving towards new entertainment like social media, YouTube. Talking about YouTube, only YouTube has around 2.3 billion users, which is a huge audience platform for any entertainer or any content creator. Then since aviation is something which excites people, which makes people to think more about it and know more about it, which has a very good craze among people. So the knowledge that aviation people can share on platforms to these people, or the people who want to learn about it, would be great, can help people, which obviously can give more subscribers. Then aviation people are constantly on a move. They move from place to place. They even visit different countries and different places, different exciting places. As their daily life routine is very good, and they can share these videos and their travel traveling videos and their traveling destinations and new things which maybe people are not aware of or may excite them to know about the new things that is happening in the world which they are not aware of can only be expected from an aviation staff. Talking about the knowledge that can be shared is like they can go for videos on new aircrafts that are coming or used in an aviation, or sharing about their technical tricks or the tricks that are used in any aviation company which outsiders cannot know can also excite people. Talking about the reasons why, so we have understand why bloggers, cabin crews and pilots can be a good bloggers. So what are the qualities or what are the specific qualities which only bloggers, only the pilots and cabin crew bloggers can have? First is they have experience in traveling, which is much required. If you are a blogger, you can show new places, new things, and the different unique places and things. Second is knowledge about the world. Third is you are much disciplined than others. You know much more. You can do it, do work faster. You can adaptable to any situation. Which makes it much more easier for any pilot or aviation staff to do blogging. Second is they can maintain a frequency, because since you are constantly traveling, any pilot or any cabin crew is constantly traveling. So they will have a good content and a very like constant content to share with the people. Then talking about another reasons is that they can engage the customers well, because the audience well, because since you have a unique content, you will be sharing some unique facts which is not known to the people and which is not much known or shared by other bloggers. The aviation employees have a good communication skills, then presentation skills, and they are much more like experienced in all the all the blogging staffs, or all the you have much more blogging staffs than any other bloggers. So we have a lot of bloggers recently working as part-time and full-time bloggers who turned from a pilot to a blogger. So most of them have their blogging sites, and they are very much popular. So some of what they include in them is that mostly they have their flight attendants. Mostly they have flight attendant lifestyles, or they are mostly talking about their relationship, about traveling, their day to day life, how they do work, how they can be productive, how people can be productive. Then they even talk about different destinations. They even take you to the guide, take you through the cities and other places that they will be visiting. They even talk about different food cultures of different countries or different places. They even talk about how people live there, how they have experienced visiting a certain place, how they manage their lifestyle as a pilot, or whatever is required for a pilot to be. Some blogs also give you information about the new job requirements coming in any aviation platform, or how can you embrace your career in an aviation field. Then which are the motivating specializations, or the best specializations if you want to be a traveler, or you want a traveling life, or something related to traveling. You can they talk about tourism research, travel tips, family travel, and many more including these. These are some of the best cabin crew bloggers for cabin crew blogging sites actually. So the best blogging site, which is today, is the Flight Attendant Life, and they have a followers of around 14k, which is a huge follower base. Then we have boss girl Priya, who they have of 21.7k followers. Then we have Mamta Sachdeva. She is an Indian blogger and she has a 82.9k followers. And then if you have such a huge followers, then the income you will be getting through your blogs or the viewers and the total views on your platform will be huge, and you will be like increasing it in an exponential manner every day. These are some of the pilots who are now bloggers. Some are part-time bloggers, some are full-time bloggers. Talking about pilot Maria, so she is one of the best pilot blogger now. So she mostly puts contents related to flying and travel. Mostly her blogs include selfie. Most of her posts were on Instagrams, and she has a huge fan base. And most of her bloggings were related to flying and travels, and her day to day lives and her healthy lifestyle. Then there is Pilot Patrick blog, and he also gives tips about fitness and travels. Then there is Captain Joe. Captain Joe has a huge fan base on Instagram, and he shares his travel pics, great pics of travels when he's in a cockpit or the other nature beauty related to nature pics were there on his Instagram. Then there is Foxbat Pilot, which is owned by Peter, and they mostly talks about Foxbat Pilots. Foxbat is a type of aircraft which Peter talks about mostly. Next is we have understood what blogging is, what bloggers do, and why a blogging life is much more exciting and much more you will enjoy. But let us know about some of the pilots who are now bloggers and learn from their story, what they gained, what they have now, what they achieved when they started doing blogging. So this is Sam Shui Kai Singh. He is a Chinese Australian aviation blogger. So he travels. He posts travel bloggings and photographs related to his travel content. So he has over 2 million subscribers on YouTube, and one of his famous captures was that Los Angeles International Airport. He captured that photograph, and which gathered a total of 12 million views, and it was estimated that his per day revenue is around $3,500, which is a huge amount for more than you will be anyone will be earning on their day to day life or from a regular job. Then next, these are two Indian bloggers, Gaurav Taneja and Ritu Rathi. So these two has a YouTube channel which is known as Flying Beast, and they have a 3 million subscribers on their blogs and have a huge fan base and subscribers, and they mostly share blogs and videos about their fitness and flying. Next is Madeline. She is a native from German. So she was telling about her life as a pilot. So she is a certified pilot, but after some time she could not find a job in the aviation industry. So So not wasting her time, and she wanted to use her energy and her knowledge and the positive thinking to do something productive. So she started a travel blogger, travel blogging instead of finding a job. So what she does is, she started posting all of those traveling photos and videos she had, and for now she has around 75k followers, which is like a huge following base. And she also, when she was talking about her struggles, so she once told that people always think that you are not as good as the guys. So of course in flight school she had a lot of issues sometimes when she was trying to be an instructor or anything else, so or trying to help her peers. So she because of that also she had some like her morale went down. So she thought that she could not get a job in aviation, but because of her positive thinking, she went to another lifestyle or another career path, and which is blogging, and now she is doing great job in her career. So what is there in blogging for any aviation employee? First, you will get a fame. Of course, fame is fame because as I told you about the above bloggers, they have a huge following base, 3 million followers max, which is a huge, so people will be knowing you. You will get a platform to showcase your likings, your day-to-day life or anything you want to showcase. People can follow their passion. If you are very much passionate about traveling, then you can go for it. You can share your traveling experience and you will earn a lot of money if your contents are good, if you are sharing a good content with people, if you are doing a great job in your work. You can live your dream if you are a blogger and a good blogger. You can share your experience with people. You can educate people about many things you like, which people don't know about. Also, you can use blogging as a selling platform, because if you have a great subscriber base, then if you want to sell a product, people will come and buy your product. So you can get a good platform for selling. That's all from my side. Thank you so much.